G'day, Angie Mahar here. I'm sorry to be laughing. I came across a question. I don't know who wrote it on the internet, so I'm not making light of anyone, okay? I swear, I promise. This is serious. okay, I'm sorry, really, this is serious. Could be somebody out here. I shouldn't leave this in, but I will, but I'm sorry, okay? If this offends anyone. So I'm not going to say where I got the question from. It's just a question out there. I'm sorry. Okay. Serious now, right? I'm sorry. So people really are going to maybe... Okay. So this video, if I can stop laughing, and if I can't, it becomes an outtake, right? This video is about to answer the question. I'm sorry. To answer the question... Can you make amends to your partner with borderline personality disorder? I'm sorry. I'm really sorry. It's serious. never heard or saw anyone quite put the question that way. That's all. I think I'm over it now. The laughing, I mean. I'm not laughing at, I don't know who asked it. So here, seriously now. I'm sorry. I just have to be so serious here all the time. Sometimes I just thought, I'd be a little bit me here. Okay, so, they haven't already laughed. Oh, got a cold too. Laughed. Sorry. As I compose myself here, you know, no. Okay. All straight face now. It is important, and I'm sure there are people struggling with this. How can you make amends? Or can you make amends? Yeah. Or what could you do to make amends to your partner with BPD? So, hard to imagine what situation a person may be in asking that question, and yet, I'm sorry for the laughing, because, you know, it's a serious question, obviously, where it comes from. And people, the reason I want to speak, sorry, this one's just, anyway. Well, okay, can you make amends with a person, with your partner with borderline personality disorder? First of all, you should not want to. No, that doesn't come across right. It's not in your best interest to, right? So the question, that's not what I find funny about the question. Okay, I'm sorry. But can you make amends to a partner with borderline personality disorder? Well, why would you want to? Okay, and as I say that, I know people are in cognitive dissonance. There's lots of reasons why people with BPD could be really, you know, attractive, not only, you know, physically and sexually, but otherwise, you know, because I'm not saying people with BPD are all the same or that they don't have some lovely qualities, but somebody who might ask this question or might be watching the video, and I'm sorry for the first few minutes of it, I'm getting serious now, to want to know if they can make amends to a partner with borderline personality disorder, that's to be in a really hurting place, really in all seriousness, because it's not really doable. Now, could people do it in a way, after I just said it's not doable? Yes, but it's not lastingly doable. Can I put it that way? It'll be going around a cycle again. And the other thing is, though I say that with it's not doable, but kind of yes, has it been done? Yes. I have clients who've done it. But was it in their best interest? What, did it work out? No. Did they go around the same cycles again? And some people with borderline personality disorder, they will just like walk away, leave, cheat on you, do things, just end relationship. Or I don't believe in using the same language for BPD and NPD, but they will... Well, I guess ghost for last, but you know, that's not the same as NPD, but they'll just like out of sight, out of mind you. They'll just cut you out of their mind, and so you're out of sight. And black and white thinking being what it is, that if they've already really split you, and this can happen over and over in relationships without doubt, right, with those with BPD, that they've already split you to the all black, and maybe they've been doing that for a while, you know, the idealizing and devaluing, around that cycle. And then... excuse me, the next thing you know, somehow you feel like you're in a position where you've done something, because that's the other issue in this. How can you What was my question again? Not mine, somebody else's. Can you make amends with a borderline personality disorder partner? Well, what position must you think you're in? But what do you feel like you did? What are you feeling responsible for? Are you guilty of something that you would even really need to make amends for? Or is it more likely that the person with BPD and the idealization, devaluation, the splitting, the all or nothing, black and white thinking has now tossed you because they were triggered and it was really their responsibility and maybe you didn't do anything? I mean, sometimes people are reactive to people with BPD and they'll feel bad about the ways they've acted or behaved or responded with anger and kind because they're in pain. But to make amends, it's pretty difficult, especially for many, many, many high percentage of people with BPD who will have, like, be giving you the silent treatment right now, have moved on, you're out of sight, out of mind. You know, they're not hoovering you, they've just taken off with somebody else or whatever the case. A, you got to ask yourself, what would you be making amends for? I mean, what did you do wrong that you need to make amends for versus that you might have a desire to do whatever you can to have the relationship continue because you believe somehow this can be worked out or they will get treatment or they will change or you might not be thinking about all that. It might just be that the sex was great, they were really intense. You know, point is anyway, ask yourself first, what is it you have to make amends for? Did you really do something? Chances are, even if you did, that's not what caused a relationship breakup. And if you did, if you didn't do anything really wrong or inappropriate, and it's really about the borderline person with BPD's splitting and out of sight, out of mind, black and white thinking, having moved on, then there's really probably not going to be a whole lot you can say to change their mind because often once they've done that, and it's not like a narcissist discard, but once they've done that sort of devaluing, they're gone kind of thing, which you never know if it's that or not, right? Because some will hoover back, cycle around, but some don't ever. And so if you're trying to make amends, put it this way, whether you think you have something to make amends for, whether you're just trying to get the relationship back, they are hard and fast, such black and white, all or nothing thinkers, they're probably long gone. They're probably off to, you know, two or three people down the road. And I just mean that in the sense that things aren't working out for them and they put other people out of sight, out of mind and move on. And I think that the other thing about this is that even if you could or you do feel like something that you would like to apologize for, make amends for, that was reactionary or what have you, and even if that person with BPD would listen to you or you could get a hold of them and have this conversation, then making amends to a partner with BPD is just really signing up for more of the same cyclical chaos, drama, abuse, the impossibility of trying to relate to a person with BPD who isn't emotionally mature and doesn't really know what love is. And I know this is getting, not because of me or anything, but I'm sure I don't always help for those who want to give the contrarian opinion all the time. And that is, well, I shouldn't put it that way, because not necessarily just contrarian to what I'm saying. That happens all the time. But with a lot of things, okay? But what I mean is this idea out there that without treatment, okay, so a person recovers or goes through DBT and manages BPD way better or is in a real recovery process of treatment and changing and growing and demonstrably so and taking personal responsibility without any of that, like especially without they don't take personal responsibility. What are you about to sacrifice yourself on the altar of trying to make amends to a partner with BPD for if they don't take personal responsibility? And I'm not trying to set up some, you know, tit-for-tat argument here about, well, if they did this, you shouldn't do that. Or if they're punishing you, you should punish them. No, not at all. But the point is, Can you make amends with a person with BPD? I wouldn't say it's impossible. I mean, because, you know, there's so many people with BPD that can't say never. But if a person did, and I don't know why they would feel that they would have to make amends. I mean, people can wrong people with BPD, yes. But normally it's, you know, the relationship rupture occurs based on the person with BPD's triggers and behaviors and such. So the thing is, really just to wrap it up here, okay, because this has probably been like, I'm serious now, and I was serious in the beginning, even though I thought it was sort of funny. Just hadn't heard it put that way. But so the ultimate point for this video is, these relationships, if they're untreated, if they're denying it, if they're not making really reasonable progress in therapy, which can take quite a while, so if they're not somewhere down that path, if they can't take personal responsibility, then all the amends you try to make in the world, whether heard or not, whether you're successful or not, it's all self-defeating, because some people think this opinion of mine, well, it's more than an opinion, but they think it's so wrong. But people with untreated BPD, or people who aren't really making their way down the road to recovery in treatment, are not capable of consistent, congruent, healthy adult love, which means that somebody could really be sacrificing themselves. And I put it that way on purpose, because if two people that are relatively healthy, averagely healthy in a relationship, and there's some discord and disagreement, somebody hurts somebody else's feelings, you want to make amends for that. But what are you trying to make amends for is what you really, like, I got to really dwell on that. Because did you really do something wrong, or did they just devalue, split, were they just triggered? And now they've cut you off, like, Dave, you're out of sight, out of mind. Because even if you can successfully make amends with a person with borderline personality disorder, chances are, like 90% or more, you're going to really regret it, because the cycle of splitting and devaluing and black and white thinking and idealizing and devaluing you is going to just exponentially increase, as it does throughout relationships when they're on again, off again, on again, off again. So even if you got your BPD partner to, you know, say, okay, you know, like, what, have that conversation, the relationship is going forward, you're really only doing that to another inevitable rupture. And so that's what I mean by sacrifice yourself on, you know, the altar of making amends to the BPD partner. Otherwise, I wouldn't say sacrifice yourself, but that's what's going to be happening. It's not healthy. It's not advisable. If a relationship is ended with a person with BPD, there's never any closure. If you feel somewhat responsible, you have to ask yourself, do they take any personal responsibility? You have to think about what really happened. But generally speaking, you know, with untreated people with BPD especially, you have to realize, I think, or stop and pause and really think hard about, why do you really want them back? Why do you really want the relationship to continue? And to what end? And what are you likely to go through if you are successful at trying to make amends to a BPD partner? Because usually, not always, the chances are a higher percentage than not that if somebody is in a position where they want to try to make amends to a BPD partner, and yes, I've had some clients like that. It's just the way the question was framed that was funny at first, but it's not really funny. It's not healthy to try to make amends and continue to have a relationship go on that, by its very nature of the arrested emotional development in these people with BPD, I'm not trying to put them down or stigmatize them or be all against them, they do not know how to, you know, have relationships consistently, congruently, healthy. No, they're toxic. I mean, the relationships end up being toxic. People with BPD, unless until they get a lot of treatment, know how to take personal responsibility. You're only just going to sacrifice yourself, hurt yourself, if you make amends successfully to a BPD partner who's not quite an ex yet, or wherever that might be at, which is whoever asked the question, you're setting yourself up for a world of hurt. So I would say, don't do it, and heal and move on and take care of yourself.